Oh, come on now, hold still. Stop moving around. Hold still, I said. Hold still.
What's the matter with these matches? Hold it tight.
I don't want to hold it.
Hold it tight.
You hold it.
Look out! Look out!
My eyes!
Hello, this is Nikos. I need you to pick up a bundle of tomatoes and shove them up your ass.
12, number 12.
The Jerky Boy Show with Johnny Brennan is brought to you by AdamandEve.com, America's most trusted source for adult products. For a limited time, you'll get 50% off just about any item. When you select your item, you'll also receive 3 free adult DVDs plus an extra gift. And to top it off, they'll even throw in free discreet shipping on your entire order. Just use offer code SIDESHOW at AdamandEve.com. The Jerky Boy Show with Johnny Brennan is also brought to you by FlyGrip. Do you have an iPhone, Android, or any smartphone? Well, if you do, here is the most innovative accessory for your smartphone. It's called FlyGrip. There's nothing out there like it. FlyGrip attaches to the back of your phone or phone case and gives you the ability of one-handing your phone with ease. No more juggling. Hold your phone casually with FlyGrip. FlyGrip even fits those really big Android phones. FlyGrip makes using your smartphone easier. For more information, check out FlyGrip.com and order yours today. Use promo code JERKY and get free shipping. For a limited time, get a free phone case with your order at FlyGrip.com.
Hey, Johnny. My dad let me call in. I'm a big Jerky Boy fan. I tell you what, I know you did some calls for Howard Stern there, and big fan of Howard Stern, too. And I know you did a call called Bright. I would really like to hear Bright. Any chance you could play Bright for me, I really appreciate it. Thank you, Johnny. Keep up the good work.
Dramatics in Westview, this is Scarlett speaking.
Hello.
Hello.
Is Bright there?
Yes, she is.
May I speak with her, please?
And what is this in reference to?
She cut my son's hair.
And is there something wrong?
It's ridiculous. He looks like a bulbous. He looks like a jackass now. Do you understand me?
Yeah, I understand you completely.
I mean, what is she using to cut his hair? A baseball bat? He's in the professional world, and she did an awful job.
Hold on one second. Hello?
Hello.
Okay, what is your son's name?
Is this Bright?
No, this is Scarlett.
I'm going to have to talk to Bright.
I'm the receptionist here, and I need to know exactly who is...
This is Gary's mom, Gary Delabate's mom.
Gary Delabate?
Yes.
What day was he in here?
He was in the other day, and she cut his hair. It looks like she used garden shears. He's in the bathroom puking all night all over himself. He's sick with this haircut. He looks dopier than he ever did now.
So why wouldn't he just come back in and have it fixed?
Because maybe did you ever think he's afraid? He looks so stupid. He looks even dopier than he did before.
Afraid to come back?
You know how stupid he looks in the first place, and you people cut his hair just to make fools of him. Just to make him feel like a dirty, dirty worm.
What?
It's Bright there.
She's with the client. I cannot disturb.
She did this. She did this to my boy.
Manager, okay?
What?
I'm going to give you to the manager.
Oh, God. Okay.
Hold on.
Hurry up.
Hi.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, hi.
This is Flair. Can I help you?
How many different people do I need to speak to before I get to Bright?
Oh, you wanted to speak to Bright?
Yes.
Her boss.
Well, what happened? Bright cut Gary's hair.
Bright cut Gary's hair.
She made a mess of it.
She made a mess of it?
Yes.
What would you like to do? Would you like to have him come in and have it recut?
He's my son. I love him. And he's hurt now. He's hurt.
Okay.
Everyone's making fun of him. Don't you see that? He's already got enough of a complex with that mouth of his. And his face and his fat ass, and he has enough problems.
Well, why don't you have him come in and she can recheck it?
Well, why did you do this to him? You know he's self-conscious.
All right, hold on just a minute.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Oh, please help me.
Yeah, okay, here you go.
Hello?
Yes, Bright, please.
Yeah, this is Bright.
What did you do to Gary's hair?
Who is Gary?
He's my son. Damn it, he's my son. I love him.
Hey, Calabate?
Yes.
What I did to his son? Oh, now I know. Oh, I didn't cut his hair. When he cut his hair?
He cut his hair the other day. He said
no,
you did it.
I didn't cut his hair. You know who is Gary Calabate? He worked for Howard Stern?
I don't care who he works for, damn you. You cut his hair.
I don't know who you are. I'm sorry, but Gary, I cut 2 months ago his hair. This is the producer, Howard Stern, producer who comes here. She makes a mistake. I didn't cut, Mrs., I didn't cut his hair last time.
Listen to me.
I didn't cut his hair.
He was in the bedroom all night sick, and he said Bright was responsible for this.
He went somewhere else. Yesterday, but I didn't cut his, last time when I cut his hair was 2 months ago. Sometimes he goes somewhere else.
Listen to me.
When I cut his hair was 2 months.
Will you shut your mouth for a minute and listen to me, please?
I'm listening to you, but I didn't cut his hair.
Listen to me. You told him that he would look much better with a bald cock. That's not right.
I didn't cut his hair.
You did cut his hair, you crazy bitch.
She's making me a crazy bitch, and I don't know who is this.
Listen to me. I'm going to come down there, and I'm going to kick you in your cunt. It's not right what you did to my beautiful horse-faced boy, you sick bitch.
It's the Jerky Boys Show with Johnny Brennan. Tonight, Johnny's guests include a milky licker, a sizzle chest, a barrel ass, and one slap-happy prick. And now, here's Johnny.
All right. Thanks, Jack, you silly hooey-ya. Hey, so welcome back, everybody. I'm glad you're back again this week. And I hope you enjoyed the opening there. Way up in the front there of the show, I loved it. I mean, I don't know how many times I can hear it. I love it as much as the same time as the first time I heard it with Mike with the shearing the sheep up there. And that always kills me. I love that. And I know you guys probably heard it before, but it just, that cracks me up. And the caller, one of the call-ins asked for Howard Stern. A few calls were done for the Stern show, and very interested in hearing the Bright cut. It was about Baba Booey. So what I did is I set it up so that I called Gary's haircutter, Bright, you know, obviously the name of the cut, and I called his haircutter as his mother. I was making believe I was his mom, and I called her all pissed off. What the fuck? What did you use to cut my son's hair? A baseball bat? And one of the killer lines that freaking makes me laugh is when she says that you told Harry he would look better with a bald cock. I mean, I still think that's one of the most fucking ridiculous lines ever. Yeah, and you know, it was really weird too, man. After I did those calls for the Stern show, when we went up there to do the show, you know, Gary was pissed. He took a poke at me, gave me a good chop right to the fuck, gave me a busted me right in the chops. Kamal jumps in and tries to, you know, get, and him and Gary rolled around on the floor, beat the fucking shit out of each other for a while. They, you know, security was up there. They fucking, forget about it. You know, that was a whole big to fucking do because Gary was really fucking pissed. Yeah, I mean, what a fucking mess, man. I mean, you know, it's one thing, you know, you're joking around, but then, you know, just a funny phone call, you know, and they were made for the show. And next thing you know, you're getting your fucking ass kicked and everybody's up there fucking brawling. Cops fucking, you know, real fucking mess. Yeah, and that's also one of those calls, too, that comes off of the Jerky tapes. One of the ones that we discussed in previous episodes where the fans wanted longer material. And that just so happens to be one of them. If I'm not mistaken, that's the shortest one on that, the Jerky tapes. That's the shortest running call. And I forget, you know, it's like 4 minutes, whatever it is. But yeah, and it's classic. You know, that was waiting around. That's also done at the manager Harry's apartment, man. We'd get so freaking bored there. I used to feed his cat all kinds of shit. Whatever I found in his refrigerator, I'd force feed the fucking cat whipped cream and peanut butter and all kinds of shit. You see the cat trying to lick his chops with a mouthful of fucking peanut butter. Harry kept his bike. He used to keep his bicycle right outside the main door, like a fucking 10-speeder, you know, like those English racers he used to get around the city with. I fired that fucking thing down into the courtyard with his fucking helmet and all of his shit that was out on, you know, on his porch, like his boots and whatnot. He was so fucking pissed. But it brings back nice memories, you know, nice memories for me. But anyway, I hope you guys all enjoyed Bright and give it a few listens, and you'll see some, you know, wacky shit every time you listen down to these calls, you know, a few times over. It's like watching a classic movie, you know, where you repeat all the lines. You always find some new shit, little nuances and whatnot that you just like to, you know, jerkyisms, Rizzoisms, where you throw them out there, you know what I'm saying? Things like, you know, I can't see, damn it. Or, should I bring my fucking toolbox? Open your fucking ears, jackass. And even, you know, just short little ones, little things that are like the other person on the end of the phone. I actually put this out on Facebook and Twitter and whatnot, and people get it. Like, it's funny. Just I just put the words, spell it. And everybody, it's hilarious how many people right away, they start, you know, sending me back messages, exactly the routine, and that's classic stuff, man. Just one or two words, and people are, they jump all over it. But that's what I'm talking about. And now this brings us to, you know, where, you know, the fans call in, you know, do we take the calls over over at the number there, 718-878-5668. So let's take the call and shoot some shit. All right. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, who's this?
This is Daphne. This is Daphne Andrews.
Hey, how you doing, Daphne? How's it going?
I'm doing well. Thanks so much for taking my call. One of your biggest fans.
Oh, that I appreciate that. Thanks for calling into the Jerky Boys show.
Thank you very much for having me. So, you know, let's talk about some piss clams.
How you doing there, Toots?
doing fine.
So what do you do?
I actually work in high tech, but, you know, my real passion is rescuing the pit bulls. You know, I know you have some fun with your Rottweilers there, with your sausages and the lazy boys.
Yeah, the old sausage and the lazy boy. It's a, you know, it's a real treat for me, you know?
I bet it was a real treat for the dog and your uncle, too.
Well, my uncle didn't get the, you know, the better end of the deal, but the fucking dog, you know, he's loaded up on them sausages, that's for sure.
Right on.
That's all true shit, too, by the way. That when I put that out there, I mean, that's, you know, hiding sausages in the Christmas tree to see the dog tear the tree apart, and everybody in the family's like, what the fuck's he doing? That's all, you know, and I'm sitting on the sideline looking at everything going, you know, just like having a fucking real kick out of it.
Man, I wish you could have taped that.
It's all, yeah, I know, right? But that's, you're going back, I'm going back 20 years, 25, you know, and you don't think about it back then. You don't think, holy shit, we got to, you know, some things I did get on film, though, I have to say.
That's awesome.
So
I have a couple questions I got to ask you.
All right, go ahead. Shoot.
Awesome. This is just a chance of a lifetime. Very thankful. So I got to ask you my biggest question. So I have to tell you, so back in 94, I had the flu, and my boyfriend at the time came over and put on the first tape, you know, a little cassette tape, you know, those little silly little things.
Yeah.
And I laughed so hard, it broke my fever, and I seriously have been a fan ever since. And there was one thing, though, in one of the tapes you've had since the home wrecker, you know, where the guy calls up to demolish a little black house.
Yeah.
Why did that woman, did she not sound to you honestly intrigued about the work at hand?
You talking about the one where they want to, knock down that goddamn house and put up a hot dog stand?
Yeah, and maybe she can run it.
Yeah, man, it was one of those freaky deals. You know, a lot of times you get that where somebody is slightly detached, and you're saying sometimes I might even say to myself, Jesus, Mary and Joseph. But at the end of the day, it turns out to be a classic. You know,
I couldn't believe, and honestly, I mean, I sit there and I listen to it, and I can't believe this woman is truly taking notes. I mean, she could have gotten off that conversation many times, but she was really interested.
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's work is work. And yeah, that was a real classic there. That was, I think that was off one or two.
One of those first few ones, but
yeah.
I tell you, that was great.
Yeah, I want you to break their goddamn house down and put up a hot dog stand.
So she can have the surprise of her life.
Surprise of her life. Yep.
That's,
I love
awesome.
That. That's a great bit.
And then another question I had was, big question, was Jim. It sounded like that, you said that was an inside job. Jim and the piss clams?
Oh, the piss clams call. Yeah, that was. That was a few guys, you know, record guys that were put me privy to some dude in Florida that, you know, he was doing some shit maybe he shouldn't have been, or, you know, and I just, you know, got the ball in red. And you could see it, his mother was a very old woman. And, you know, she was getting, you know, really upset that her son's, you know, creating these nudist beaches and nudist camps and whatnot. Yeah.
So my question is, did you ever find out later, because it was an inside job, if what happened when Jim came home? Because she said she was going to take care of it.
Woman,
so I was curious.
Woman, if I didn't know any better, I'd say you was a regular jackass. What the hell are you coming at me with that silly-ass question shit?
Oh, you're just upset because you've got a rear that's like cottage cheese in a plastic bag.
You got a nice pair of them goddamn baloney tits on you, woman.
Oh, my goodness. If my husband's soul, if he even came home from his two-wheeler mishap, he'd just, you know, he'd go crazy.
Yes, saw with the two-wheeler. So, it just turned out to be a big all-time favorite with the whole piss clam deal and, you know, walking on the beaches and all this other shit. You know, Sol, that was a big Sol Rosenberg classic. So, you know, it was great, man. So what else? Anything else?
Yes, I do have a couple more. So there's one, I think it was when, was it Rosine that called in about the synchronized swimming?
Yeah, that was Rosine, the Puerto Rican transvestite.
Yeah, okay, so there's like a buzzer going on, and he keeps exclaiming like in pain, well, like a shaver.
Are you telling me that you don't get that, what's going on there? Why, you sneaky little, you got to be kidding me, that's a vibrator.
Oh, my God, I am so square. I am so...
Yeah, Rosine, what I tried to put across to people, here's Rosine, you know, calling in, and while Rosine is trying to make a phone call, like, maybe it's a partner, or, like, because Rosine refers to somebody. Like,
right,
she's
exactly.
Like, right, she's like, mira, ay, stop it, coño. It's like somebody's, while she's trying to talk on the phone, somebody's using the old vibrator on her.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You know, it's funny. It's funny that you say that, because now I put it out to the listeners out there. If they felt like you, or if they knew or didn't know that it was a vibrator, you know, that's very interesting, because I didn't think anybody would have with any doubt in their mind that that's what was going on.
Well, you know, I actually would love to hear your feedback on Facebook or something. People, what they think about that from when you post this podcast, because I didn't get that.
That's pretty wild, yeah, because that was an actual in-studio vibrator, too, so there was no mistaking, you know, the sound. But, yeah, it was just supposed to be Rosine getting annoyed with some, lover or whatever that's, you know, trying to rub her down with her vibrator while she's trying to talk on the phone. But, yeah, that's another classic, man. That's a Rosine. I love that character.
That is, did you know somebody like that? Is that how you... got
to Rosine? Yeah, just different neighborhoods I grew up in. I think I mentioned this before. You know, when I was a kid, I used to always love to listen to just different voices and, you know, you name it, whether it's Greek or Spanish or, you know, just different dialects and even, like I said, gay voices and stuff. When I was a kid, I used to love to just copy voices. So, you know, I grew up in a neighborhood where we had plenty of Puerto Ricans, lots of Greeks, and so there was a lot of stuff for me to go with there.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
so I got one big... Sorry, No.
I was just saying, Rosine, that's all.
So my other last big question that's... just this one's really weighted on my mind. I got to tell you, what are we going on, 20 years now? When Tarbosh says, I punch my chest and it disappears in the crowd, what the hell does that freaking mean?
Well, you know, that was classic. You know, Kamal just threw that out there, and to this day, everybody loves that. And I love the lady on the line too. She's like, okay, I get it. You punch your chest and it disappears into the crowd. Okay,
and then I choked the faculty staff.
Yeah, I choked the faculty. Yeah, but no, that's you know what it is. That's the classic Jerky Boys routine, is where, you know, each of the characters is so beloved that they all have these wacky little quirks that people go, what the fuck? Where did that come from? And it's like, it's just classic off the wall shit, you know, like, you know, the dentist malpractice where he's in the chair, he wakes up with a big red shanker on him, you know, something must have been going on, you know?
Yeah. The innocence is just beautiful.
Yep.
And thank you.
You got it.
Thank you so much for what you do. You make all of us laugh. You bring a smile to the world.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
And so, hey, I just got to say one last thing. I think you were going to play the third part of The Flower Lady today, and I would just love to hear the end of that bit.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So you're a fan of The Flower Lady bit, huh?
The way she turns from being so, like, victimized from the first to trying to be the aggressor on the second, I can't wait to hear what she does on the third.
You know what's great? I get so many great on, you know, Facebook or emails coming in where people are going nuts over this Flower Lady. Because, you know, let's face it, a lot of people don't. This is nice because I have a lot of CDs that people haven't heard a lot of this stuff. So now everyone's hearing this for the first time, and the emails are pouring in. People can't wait for the third spot. So that's what I'm saying. That's how this stuff goes, you know, goes viral. People, and then she's... And one of the fans wrote in, it was hilarious, for a $49 fucking dollar floral arrangement, this woman's going through fucking hell. And so, yeah, it worked out great. So I'll definitely play that for you.
Thanks so much, man. And I have to tell you, you know, I look up on YouTube or other places for prank calls. No one can hold a candle even close to you. I mean, you are the king. Oh. So just remember that and thanks for making us laugh.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
All right. Well, you take care.
Thank you. Listen, thanks for the call, and I really appreciate that. And I'll get the Flower Lady part number 3 right up there for you.
Awesome. Thanks.
Thanks, Daphne. See you later.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks again, Daphne. And thanks for the kind words. I appreciate that. And also the good, you know, the good feedback. A lot of good stuff in there and, you know, stuff that the listeners might want to check out. So, yeah, let me get it up for you because I promised, you know, last week we've been doing good with it now. I'm not missing. I missed the first one. The first part of the Flower Lady is I think it's in 8 or 9. And then I missed, I think, a show or two. Like I totally got sidetracked. But last week was the Flower Lady. We got a tremendous response. And, it did really well. And a lot of people emailed and said, holy geez, they couldn't believe what they were hearing. And so I'm not going to waste any more time. I'll get right to the third part in the trilogy, Flower Lady, part 3. All right, so here it goes.
Hi, you've reached 7.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, this is Diane calling for Mr. Getzoff, please.
Is that better? Hello?
Yes.
Who is this? Hello?
I'm going to lose my patience. Diane Stein.
Oh, yes. I spoke to you before.
Yes, I did. I spoke to you.
Yes. What can I do for you, please?
Where's Mr. Getzoff?
No, he's not here right now. He's not I don't believe he's back yet. I'm still finished working. I'm still working on this, Huh?
Okay, you know what? Is Mr. Getzoff going to be there at 2 o'clock?
I do not know. Listen, I am hired to fix something. I don't know.
Is this the superintendent of the building?
No, I am fixing a thing in his apartment.
Okay, you know what?
You're yelling at me. I don't know why you're yelling at me for.
Because I spoke to you before.
But why are you yelling at me?
I spoke to you before, and you were very rude.
When was I ever to spoke to you?
You and your friend were very rude to me.
I've never rude to you. I've been working.
Stop yelling. You were very rude.
I was not rude to you.
Rude.
What do you mean rude?
Very rude.
I'm not rude to nobody.
Put Jack on the phone.
You want to speak to Jack?
You know what? I'm just going to send over arrangement.
You want to speak to Jack? Hello?
Do you have that arrangement?
Do you want to speak to Jack?
Bring it over here, because I'm just going to messenger it. I'm not going to keep to the phone calls all day.
You want to speak to Jack?
With this one
who
doesn't even speak English, mind you.
What do you mean I don't speak English?
You don't speak English.
I know English better than you.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
What does iconoclast mean?
I don't know.
Then I know English better than you.
It's not a word.
It is too a word.
I'm joking. It's not
a word. It's iconoclast. It means breaker of idols. Icons.
Excuse me.
That's what it means.
This is not the classroom. I don't care what a word means or what a word does.
You're bringing horrible memories of when I'm in school.
I am sending over the floor lady.
The teacher used to whip me.
Give me the and I'll switch it over, because even if he doesn't like it, I don't care. I don't care. I don't care if the money is wasted at this point. Give me the address. I'm going to have it messaged.
You want the address?
Yes.
Then you must speak to Mr. Scott.
No, you did this to me before with Scott.
What the hell? Who am I? This is not my house.
Give me the number.
This is not my house.
On.
You want to speak to the other fellow?
Come on now.
Then you must speak to Mr. Scott.
I don't want to speak to Scott. What's that noise?
Now you're getting everyone angry.
How many people are over there?
We're doing a lot of work. This big wedding taking place. I'm hired to make a...
The wedding isn't taking place yet, because I'm the one who's supposed to do the flowers, so our other wedding isn't taking place.
I'm going to give you
yet.
The phone to this gentleman.
Hello?
Is this Jack?
Hi. How are you?
It's Diane.
Hi.
Listen, I'm going to have this messaged over to you.
Okay, great.
Will you please give it to Harry later?
Absolutely.
Give me the address. I'm having it messaged.
Okay.
I don't care anymore if he uses it or if he doesn't, because it's been sitting here since Friday.
Oh.
So it's gone to waste anyway, as far as I'm concerned. And I have my other people to deal with.
Okay, so you want the address?
Can you bring that over, please, the floral arrangements?
Yes, okay, I'll give you the address when... Hello?
Yeah, I know it's that...
Hello. Yes, hold on. I'll give you the address. address. 1 minute.
Hello?
Yeah, are you giving me the address?
This is me again.
Yes, I know it's you. It's me again. I know
this is the man that doesn't speak English. That's speaking English to you.
On the phone.
Oh, do you want to speak to Jack?
You have the address. I thought you were the superintendent of the building.
You want to speak to Jack?
I don't know how to speak English, but at least you might know the address.
I know how to speak English. Do you know to what iconoclast means?
You know how to speak English. Then give me the address at the building that you work at.
You want to know the address?
Yes, I want to know the address. Very good. Very good. You understand good, don't you?
Then you must speak to Mr. Scott.
No, Mr. Scott!
Hello?
Yeah, give me the address,
Hi.
Please.
Okay, yes. Mr. Tarbosh will give you the address. Hold on.
Mr. Tarbosh, and who are the people there? It's almost 2 o'clock now, so Mr. Gretzov must be there already.
He should be in momentarily.
Listen to me.
Yes,
be very, very clear.
Okay, Mr. Tarbosh.
I want either the number of the fiancé or the address there, because I'm going to have the centerpiece sent over to you.
Okay, we'll give you the address right here. Hello?
Now. Hello?
Hello? Yes, Mr. Tarbosh will give you the address. Hold on.
Jack, you said you had the address.
Hello?
Are you the superintendent?
No, I'm the person that doesn't speak English.
Oh, that's very funny. Oh, you're very funny now, aren't you? You're cute.
You think I'm cute?
You were on Friday.
You know, I am very cute.
But you're cuter today. You know, they're giving me more trouble today than you did on
I'm
Friday.
I'm very cute. You know,
more trouble today.
You know, you ever get that feeling when you come out of the bathtub and your skin is nice and open? I feel very open, very much open.
I'll tell you what's open is your ass. I'm very angry.
That is open, too.
Give me the address or give me the fiancé's number. It's now 2
My fiancé number?
What time is it?
My fiancé is...
Time. Do you know how to tell time?
I could tell the time.
I'm calling you back.
You calling me back?
Hello?
Did I tell you? Crazy, crazy shit or what, man? I mean, think about it. For a little fucking centerpiece and all that problems with the volcano and all that other shit, just a nonstop fucking crazy shit. And you know what makes it even funnier is, like a jackass, I've been saying I'm going to play all 3 parts and, you know, the Flower Lady trilogy, and I'm saying to myself, Jesus, I thought big old badass Bob, he was in this skit too, and I'm listening to it down and saying, I started to shit myself. I said, what the hell? I'm telling everybody a trilogy, and like a jackass, it's got the last part has big old badass Bob and all kinds of characters in and out, and really fucking blowing it up. But so that I'll play next week. So my mistake, and I'm very apologetic, very, very, very sore about that. So. Anyway, so hey, that makes it good in one way, right? So we got one more, the finale, number 4. So I'll play number 4 next week. And where do you hear that, man? It's insane. But, you know, I just can't believe how dopey. I totally forgot that there was a number 4. For whatever reason, I don't even know what the hell made me think it was a trilogy. But anyway, we got number 4 coming up next week.
Hello? Hello, yes. What? Hello? What the hell was that? Damn it.
No. Yes. Who's this?
Yes, hi, it's me. It's me, damn it. It's me, Saul. Oh, can you hear me or not? Is this damn thing on? Oh.
So I figured I'd call you and I'd fucking run some threats by you.
Now I'm very angry here. You buy this fucking car, I'll break your fucking head. Maybe choke a few people here, and that is about it.
All right, now I'm gonna break his fucking head. And don't have me come down here for you either, okay?
You know, you piss me off one way, you go the other way. I put a shoe so far up your ass, I get really pissed off fast.
I'll work circles around you. I'll wrap your fucking head in with a ratchet.
I ought to split your nuts from your head to the back of your ass. Look, you jerky little ass, I ought to split your nuts off the side of your face. You're angry at me now. Maybe I ought to come down here and fucking make you beat your fucking shoe.
I'm gonna come up there and beat that fucking kid in front of you. And remember, if you don't show up, I'll come get you.
And I'll also give you 2 slaps across your fucking mouth because I like you.
He was up here 5 minutes ago. I had to punch him in his mouth. I had to whack him in his fucking mouth. What the hell's going on with this crap? You get him back at that restaurant, and I'm going to come down here and straighten him out in front of you. I think there's going to be a lawsuit here. I'm going to punch that little bastard.
having a pair of cement shoes. Because I tell you, if you don't, I'll stick them fucking needles in your fucking face. You hear me? I'll stick them in your fucking head.
Hey, I'll rub a hot tamale in your fucking mouth, you wise guy.
That man is liable to, during a commercial break, punch your fucking mouth loose.
So I'm going to dance all over you, you scumbag. I'm going to do a dance right in your fucking ass.
How about I come there right now and lick you down?
Is there a problem with that? I'll come down there and I'll hack the bitches to death myself.
The way I could punch you in the mouth, I would slug you right in the gut. Yeah, I hit you in the gut and then I would punch you right in your mouth.
And I'll fill you up like a fucking, like a, my little turtle.
All right, look, you fucking piece of shit. Get off the fucking phone, Frank. I'm down and kick you in the cock.
I'm gonna go take a pipe to that son of a bitch. I'm gonna do that. He's a wise-ass punk, and I'm gonna wind up punching him in the fucking mouth.
I kill you! I kill you!
911 emergency response.
You know, I just, some guy tells me in the street today I park a little too close to his car. I busted his jaw for him.
I'm gonna come there. I'm gonna break your fucking leg.
I'm gonna come down and split an ear off you, woman.
They're trying to show me this, that. I fired the two of the fuckers off on their fucking head. My wife's up there poking around. She's making like she knows what the fuck is up. I fired her down onto the fucking car. So I had to go up there. I threw the two fuckers right down in the yard. Split their fucking heads. Out of here.
Just the way you're screaming at me, I could slap you silly. I have a good mind to just lick you down.
No, you know what I could do? I'll put the sweet gas in the fucking thing and I'll try to soften you up. Maybe I'll get a piece off you.
Listen to me. I'm going to come down there and I'm going to kick you in your cunt.
I split the old lady's ass in that fucking thing. Well, you split the old broad's ass in the log splitter. You put her legs in that fucking thing, you crush them up a bit, she won't open that mouth too much. And I'm going to fucking burn the joint down tomorrow night anyway. Fucking bring the plate down.
Daddy, you son of a bitch, if I come out there, I'll shoot you in your crack, you motherfuckers!
I gotta get out and straighten these motherfuckers out there now.
I mean, if you keep raising, I'll slap your face with this.
No, 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 you won't!
He's a fucking douchebag. I slapped him silly last night. He will slap you all over the place. Well, he will slap you crazy if you come off
this way. Okay, you know I'm a hang up now.
Okay, people. Hope you enjoyed the show. I threw that nutty little tune up there for you guys for your enjoyment. So hope you enjoyed the show, and look forward to see you guys all back next week. And remember the number, 718-878-5668. Call in and give a few good jabs right to the old gut. All right? And remember, Facebook at Jerky Boys Johnny, and Twitter at Jerky Boys Johnny. And check out thejerkyboys.com. Cool shit there, you know, cool stuff, all personalized, whatever you want. All right there, Chief, get out there and check it out. All right, Charlie. Yeah, and as always, have a great week and an even better weekend. All right there, Nibble Nuts. All right, tune in next week. Have some fun. Go Giants.
Call me in color. Speak to me in tongues.